I'm Ashton Addison from EventChain for Investment Pitch Media and the Crypto Coin Show. And today on Blockchain Interviews, we have David Moss, the CEO of StrongBlock. David, welcome to the show and thanks for taking the time to be here today.
Oh, Ashton, thank you. It's a pleasure.
It's my pleasure. And I would love to kick off the interview with just a little bit of background on yourself in the blockchain space and what led you to starting StrongBlock.
Well, I started off working in blockchain really seriously just about 4 years ago. We were working, I was doing a lot of white paper work and other things for a group of people in what was called Blockchain Beach in the Santa Monica area. A whole bunch of different projects came out of that. And I happened to live near there. And I was doing a number of white papers, helping a lot of people behind the scenes. And I was approached by a group that was helped put together Block One. And Block One was the company that launched EOSIO software, the EOS mainnet. And so that was about 4 years ago right now. And they asked me to, in one evening when we were all sitting around, they said, hey, we want you to be part of our core team. And I said, I'm busy. I said, well, so I eventually relented and went to work, flew out in a couple of weeks. About a week later, I was with Dan Larimer in Blacksburg, Virginia. And so it's ever since it's been Block One and then StrongBlock. And so 4 solid years of blockchain. Before then, I was a technology guy working at Oracle and Edmunds.com and other places, but completely all in for the last 4 years, 24/7.
Very cool. And I'm familiar with Blockchain Beach, and I think that's a great place to get into blockchain, first of all. And Block One is an amazing project and group of people as well.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Definitely.
We learned a lot. We always likened it to every month that we were there. It was like a year on the outside. You come out and you're a year older after a month of working on it. But it was great. We did a lot of cool stuff. And I think that it's seeing a resurgence as well. It's a lot of it is just, you know, there's so many different things going on in blockchain right now. But that's essentially the background. I've been in technology for quite a while, coming out of the Oracle database background. But blockchain all the way. Ethereum is where we started. I started off writing a layer two, did a white paper and was about to launch for a layer two Ethereum project, and then went to work at Block One instead.
Very interesting. And I know you're still helping with Ethereum with StrongBlock, and I'd love to get a high level overview and the focus and the vision that you have with StrongBlock.
Sure. I think that we've been doing the last couple of years is we've been kind of trying to find out what's really going to work in the marketplace. And the original vision of StrongBlock was to be blockchain as a service and then nodes as a service. In other words, providing something that non-technical people could use to launch blockchains and then nodes. With blockchains, we had our product ready and we were out there launching. We launched thousands of blockchains and we got the full product out there and really going. We had a bunch of enterprise clients, and then COVID happened. And so I lost a lot of those bigger clients, and we were already building nodes as a service. And we thought, well, you know, how do we do this so we incentivize people that really want to be able to participate? So we built nodes as a service that literally allows anybody to create their own node in just a couple of clicks, and they can launch it right now, only Ethereum 1.0. But the vision is blockchains are very unstable. They don't have a lot of people that are compensated. They have the miners are compensated. Typically, you've got a handful of miners that are actually making any money on Ethereum or Bitcoin or whatever, and everybody else is monitoring it, but they're not getting any compensation. Our goal was start off by compensating them out of our own community fund and then add on other new nodes and new protocols as we went so that they would be funded by those protocols. The more nodes you get, the more stability you get, the more resilience you get. So that's been the model that we've been working on since about a year ago. We've been all in on the nodes as a service part.
Mm-hmm. Very cool, David. And you mentioned you were working on blockchain as a service and you lost a lot of those large clients. And now you're saying it's really quick and easy to set up these nodes as a service in this new way that you're doing it with StrongBlock. Are you catering to still the institutionals, but is this also just available for any person that's just getting into crypto? Like a regular person can just run their own node really easily?
That's a great question. And one of the things that we've been looking at is that we found on the enterprise side, we had a lot of adoption from developers who worked at enterprises, but the enterprises themselves had already pretty much decided on Ethereum and Hyperledger. And we were out there shilling, you know, getting people excited about EOSIO. And EOSIO was kind of a harder sell there. So with the node service, the node front end service, those things are available for enterprises. But the primary use that we're seeing of them is people are using them like they would use Infura. They're using them to be able to do to work with their wallets. They're using them as their own node. Vitalik Buterin had said when he first launched Ethereum, he envisioned that all of us would have one node. You know, you'd have your own node, right? Mm-hmm. All of your processing would be done locally and then sit into the main system. Too technical, too much information. So mm-hmm. our goal, yes, is to make it available for people to easily launch, but then also available for people to easily use. On the enterprise side, we're starting to see some of that adoption. You'll see that coming out in the next quarter. But right now, it's really kind of like it's almost peer-to-peer, where people are launching and using nodes on a personal basis.
Mm-hmm. That's really cool. And I really like that you're helping fulfill Vitalik's original vision of Ethereum. That is just super cool. And to be able to run your own node is a special thing. And I think a lot of people don't really understand the full scale of what it means to be able to run your own node and what that means for your wallets and everything surrounding that. And I know that there are, in the past, there's other blockchains of a service that are helping enterprises or people trying to spin up nodes for individuals. Is there something specifically unique and competitive advantage and differentiates StrongBlock from other DeFi protocol platforms that are also helping run nodes?
Yes, we look at some of the other groups out there like Block Daemon and Pocket Network and how they're incentivizing things. And they're really looking at bringing on the nodes and selling those nodes as a service. But there really is no, it's not particularly easy or fast. Mm-hmm. And it's also, there's really no reward mechanism for people to do that. There's no incentivization. And our one of the things I didn't really mention is we're looking at healthy nodes. For example, Berlin hard fork that happened last mm-hmm. week. A lot of people weren't ready for that. There were a lot of problems that happened with it. And the idea is if you have the nodes up and running and healthy, they're going to survive the next hard fork that happens. Berlin mm-hmm. was a hard fork, but everybody follows it. That's now what we're using on Ethereum. The goal here is to, for us, the differentiation that we see is that it's extremely easy to do. Even with blockchain as a service, it was literally 3 minutes from the time that you entered in the information. We could create your private keys for you and send them out and everything you needed. 3 minutes for your up and running blockchain that was producing blocks. Right now, it's a couple of minutes at the most between the time that you put your information in, and it's two clicks, enter some information, and you have a node. So it's easy to use and rewards for doing so, for rewards for mm-hmm. participation. We think that those two things together set us apart. And when we start adding new node protocols, that will really set us apart, as you'll be able to participate across that ecosystem.
Definitely. And that's good to know. And I did read that with the Berlin hard fork with Ethereum, there was a bunch of nodes that went out of sync. Over 10% of the nodes, I believe, were lacking. There was something wrong with the software. It didn't update properly. And then they were out of the loop on having the latest version of the blockchain. So that's great to hear.
Exactly. We actually prepared for that too. One of the things that we did was made sure that all of the nodes that we have out there, and there's over 20,000 of them, we went through and did the updates across all of them so that they were Berlin hard fork ready with the latest version 24 hours before it actually went live.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. And you mentioned a couple times now about the rewards as well. And I want to touch on that. And I'm guessing that has to do with the Strong token. Can you just talk about the functionality of the Strong token within StrongBlock, the ecosystem, and does it create a sustainable ecosystem for all of the participants?
Yeah, and that's so sustainable is really the key word. I think that's the thing that we've been really focusing on, is that we started off, and you can look at, if you go and look at the chart, you'll see that we started off back last fall, September mm-hmm. timeframe, and we didn't even have a launch of a product yet. We just had a token. And the goal was always to provide rewards for people participating, but those rewards would be recycled through a number of different kinds of mechanisms. So now, once we got to December, we burned a lot of tokens. We did a lot of other things. We now have a sustainable ecosystem. Well, it's not quite sustainable. We still have inflation. We just did what's called a halving, like Bitcoin. We cut all rewards in half because the price has gone up significantly enough to justify that. But the goal is to have it so that the ecosystem itself, with all the various things that we're adding in that we'll talk about in the next couple of minutes, that over the next two quarters, we want to go to net zero inflation. Right now, mm-hmm. there's still some inflation. We set aside Strong specifically for the community. We did not do a fundraising event for the token. We used it primarily for the community, and a considerable amount of that has been distributed. Mm-hmm. So the goal is to have it so that there's as much coming in as there is going out on any given day. And we're getting closer to that with the halvening, but there's several steps. We see three more steps that need to happen, and then maybe some beyond that. But we are moving towards that every week.
Very cool. And yeah, the halvening, I didn't know that was happening, and that you're really keeping it as a part of the community. And I think that's a part of why it has, the whole platform overall has grown in value, and I've been following it. And so I think that your team's doing a great job with that. And I know that you're continuing to give back to the community, and you have some other reward platforms and other ways to give back. And one of them is NFTs. Maybe you can touch on a little bit on that and what to expect in the near future here.
Well, yes, as a matter of fact, one of the things we wanted to do is, I'm going to push this up right now in the background, and it may take a sec for it to go on there. So you can see this, and I'll move out of the way in just a little bit. But we started off by allowing everybody who had created a node with us, whether it's a bring your own node, a BYON, or a NAS, a nodes as a service node, to qualify for a bronze NFT by December 31st, 2020. And that was around, I think it was, the exact number was 3,622 nodes qualified. And we have close to 21,000 nodes now. So that was a pretty special offering. What we do is that by having the rewards, which we just did, if you're holding a bronze token, you'll be able to get a higher level of rewards. And there's other things that you'll be able to get from these tokens, and other different systems that we're building up, opportunities to be first in line for new protocols, various other things like that. But those will vary. We don't have all of them established yet, because a lot of it depends on partners. We are then going to be offering, and I'll close this up for just a sec so you can see this. This is the coming soon of the gold, the silver, gold, and platinum. These are just still frames from these three things. And I've done videos for the last 3 weeks with the background of each of these, just a piece of a still frame. So you're the first person that's actually seen these outside of the company. And your audience then when this goes out. And so what we've been working on is that each of those will be more rare than the previous one. So with platinum, there'll be only, you know, a very, very small amount. And you'll be able to use those for other different privileges within our ecosystem, different kinds of rewards, different access, different staking pools, different things you can participate in. And there's other stuff that's coming beyond that. And so we're calling it NiftyFi, and you even see that up there in the background, is a good friend of mine, actually, I'm pretty sure someone else coined the term besides him, but his name is Kurt Braggett. He has a company called Popstan, and Kurt is in the middle of all of the NFT stuff going around. I hope that this doesn't make it so he can't even have time to talk with me anymore, but he's already doing some amazing stuff in NFTs, working with Wax and Flow and some other things. But one day he tweeted, you know, the next big thing is NiftyFi, because he and I talk all the time about this, and it's Nifty's NFTs with DeFi components. And that's what we're really looking at, is having an NFT, we believe, needs to be more than just some cute piece of art, which, you know, we all love them, but we want it to be functional as well. And that really exposes the underlying cool part, is they're all smart contracts, right? It's smart contracts on a blockchain. So with a smart contract on a blockchain, you can do all sorts of cool stuff. We recognize in our ecosystem, if you have bronze token number 135, we know when you're staking it that you are in possession of bronze token number 135. Mm-hmm. We can do a lottery and say bronze token 135, today you're the winner of X. So we can directly identify that. We can give you special privileges if you're below in a certain number range. We can do all sorts of other things with that. That's really the beauty of what NiftyFi is going to happen. Some people are saying NFT 2.0. We call it functional NFTs, and NiftyFi, the term that Kurt coined. I don't know if he coined it, like I said, but we started really using that. So we're even adopting it, as you can see in the background right here.
Mm-hmm. Very cool, David. And I'm really excited to see these functional NFTs. And from what I understand, they're actually not a still frame. There are animated and interactive as well.
That is quite correct. I think that the loop time on them is about 15 seconds or so. If people have seen our bronze token, it's a spinning coin, and very simple. These are, I guess the best way to describe it is each one of these uses fractals. Mm-hmm. And so it's much more complicated and much more interesting. And you could just sit and stare at them. I mean, they're beautiful. They're collectible. The gentleman that did this work for us, and I don't want to disclose his name because I want to make sure he I've worked with him for years and years. He is a Hollywood visual effects supervisor. Mm-hmm. And he's worked on, I think, over 30 movies and a number of different music, television things, all sorts of stuff for different large organizations. And he and I have worked on projects on music video projects for years. But he is our primary artist working on these things. And he has a team of people that are developing them. So it just, it'll be blown away. It's just amazing. But you can see just from these stills that they're pretty intriguing.
Mm-hmm. Definitely, David. And for the viewers that have not yet got involved with StrongBlock and they're interested in learning more about these NFTs, getting nodes set up, what's the best way for them to get a hold of these and get involved in the community as quickly as they can?
Well, we've tried to make it as simple as possible. We do have people to go to strongblock.com and they can get a little bit of background about the project. There's links to some of the different things we have. We do have a flash paper. So we have Medium that has our flash paper and some other different things to read out there. Those are all linkable from app.strongblock.com as well. And you can go right into app.strongblock.com and you can click on one button to create your node and you fill out a form, just two pieces of information. You have to have a wallet. Ideally, you're on Chrome browser and you're using MetaMask. It works on several other different browsers and several other different wallets. And we've even had people use Nano Ledgers and things like that. But ideally, again, you go to app.strongblock.com. You'll look at the nodes tab and then you'll look at what you need to do to fill things out, and you can read some other background information. You'll have your MetaMask wallet up and everything ready to go. And it's pretty easy to get everything started. If you wish to get a bronze token right now, again, those are all given out, but they are for sale on OpenSea. Mm-hmm. We have a partnership with OpenSea where the entire library of Strong will be the collectibles. We have bronze and then silver, gold, platinum will be available there as well. And so that's how you get involved. Pretty straightforward, very easy to get started. Again, you can see that sometimes we'll have days when we have 300 or 400 people creating nodes that have never done anything like that before in their lives. Mm-hmm. Just brand new to MetaMask and brand new to Ethereum. They're still able to figure it out in a couple of minutes.
Very cool, David. And I will leave all those links as well in the description box below for the viewers. All the best with the rest of these updates moving forward. I'm excited to see the release of these NFTs in the near future, and let's follow up in the near future.
That would be great. Again, Ashton, thank you so much for having me on your show. Really appreciate it, and a big fan too.